Hi guys, it's Marty Dredd here from letsbuildwp.com, and in this video we're going to be covering how to install WordPress on Bluehost in 2019. It's only going to take us a few minutes to do this, so if you're ready, let's get started. Okay, so before we can install WordPress, we first just need to create a Bluehost account if we don't already have one. So we just need to open up our internet browser and go to www.bluehost.com. Or alternatively, you can just click the link in the description below, which will open it up in a new tab for you. Then if we hover over hosting at the top and click shared hosting, this is going to show us the three different plans they offer. To be honest, the Choice Plus plan is a little bit of overkill when we're just getting started, which really just leaves it between these two. So if we're only planning to have one blog, we can go for the basic plan, or if we're planning on building more than one blog, we can go for the Plus plan. As I'm just doing this for the tutorial, I'm going to go for the basic plan, and once we've decided, we can click the Select button underneath. That's then going to bring us to this page, which is where we can register our free domain that comes with our account. So we just need to type the domain name we're wanting to register into this box. Then we can choose our domain extension and click Next. When we do this, we should hopefully see a message saying our domain's available, and then we can fill out our personal billing information underneath. Then under Package Information, we can choose how often we'd like to pay for our hosting, and we'll also see our domain and SSL certificate are both free. Then under this, there are four optional add-ons. I normally uncheck these myself, but if you want any of them, just leave the boxes checked. Then underneath, we'll see our final bill, along with how much we're saving. At the time of recording this video, we get 33% off our bill if we choose to pay yearly. Then if we change it to 24 months, we get 41% off. And finally, if we change it to 3 years, we get 50% off our order. So we really do save quite a bit of money if we buy more at one time. And if you're not seeing the discount, just try visiting Bluehost again through the link in the video description below to see if that helps. I'm going to make sure I always keep the link up to date. Then, once we're happy with everything here, we just need to enter our payment details underneath. And if we don't want to use a credit card, we can click where it says More Payment Options and choose PayPal instead. Then finally, we just need to check these two boxes at the bottom, and then click the Submit button to check out. So I'm just going to quickly pause this video while I fill out my personal information and pay for my order, and then I'll restart the video when I'm done. So if you're following along at home, just go ahead and pay for your order, and then come back to the video, and we can carry on together. Okay, so that's me now back, and when we finish paying for our order, we'll be brought to this confirmation page, and at this point we're going to click where it says Set Password. Then here we can enter the password we're wanting to use for logging into our site, check the box to agree to the terms, and click Next. And now if we click Login, WordPress is going to start installing right away. It's only going to take a few seconds, and once it's done, we'll be shown a few different themes we can use for our WordPress blog. If we see one we like the look of, we can hover over it and click Use this theme. Or if we don't see one we like, we can click Skip this step at the bottom and choose a different one later. But either way, once we do this, we can click Start Building and we'll be logged into what's known as our WordPress dashboard. And this is where we can add any content or make any changes to our blog, which, by the way, is now live online. But just before we visit our blog, I want to quickly cover how to install WordPress if we already passed the auto setup process. It's done a little bit differently, but it's just as easy. So if this is the case with you, we just need to log into our Bluehost account, choose My Sites on the left, and then click Create a Site in the top right. Then here we're going to enter our blog title, our tagline, and click Next. Now we can choose the domain name we're wanting to use from this drop-down list and click Next. This is going to start WordPress installing for us, and it's only going to take a few seconds. Once it's done, we can click Login to WordPress, and we'll be logging into our WordPress dashboard. Now, there is a welcome gate on our blog at the moment that looks like this, but we can click where it says Coming Soon at the top, and then if we click this Launch Site button, our blog will now be completely live online. Or we can hold off on this until we've added some content. Then if we click our site title in the dark grey bar running along the top, we can visit our blog, which at the moment just has some demo content, and will either be using a demo theme like mine, or the theme we chose during installation. Then to get back to the dashboard, we just need to click our site title again at the top. So that's us now at the end of this quick tutorial video, and that was how to install WordPress on Bluehost in 2019. I really hope you found it helpful, and if you did, please give it a like here on YouTube to show your support, and be sure to subscribe to the channel for more WordPress tutorials published every week. Then if you want to learn some more cool stuff we can do with WordPress, just click the playlist that should be on screen now that contains some of my best and most popular videos. Once again, my name's Marty Dredd from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you very much for watching my video.